On July 16, 1948, in a remote desert outside San Antonio, New Mexico, the first atomic bomb was successfully detonated at the Trinity site. The nuclear blast was so intense, it fused the desert sand into glass, and you can still find some shards of that radioactive green glass if you visit the site today. Since then, 13,000 nuclear devices have been constructed and more than 2,000 detonated. With just how many nuclear devices there are, it's not surprising that nuclear knowledge has spread far and wide. Even states like North Korea, on the brink of starvation and collapse, seem to be able to make nukes, and the internet is full of how-tos on how to make an at-home nuclear reactor. With all this publicly available knowledge, it's worth asking, could your average Joe, with no formal training or special security clearances, build a nuclear device? Just know that by getting this far into the video, you're already on a dozen government lists, and let's jump in. If you ever find someone on YouTube talking about how to make a nuclear bomb, they usually only explain how to build a bomb from all the components. But building a nuke is actually pretty easy. It's getting your hands on all the components that's the hard part. That's because nuclear devices start with the nuclear, not the device. This lesson brought to you by your fourth grade English teacher. The foundation for most nuclear bombs is uranium. It's the heaviest naturally occurring element, and when split, it can provide a tremendous amount of energy. There are about 40 known uranium mines throughout the world, but most uranium comes from these 10 mines in Canada, Australia, Niger, Kazakhstan, Namibia, and Russia. Now, before you think about sneaking into a Russian uranium mine and finding yourself in a real-life gulag, let's talk about how much raw uranium you need to make a bomb. Uranium occurs naturally in three different isotopes: U-234, U-235, and U-238. The good news is you'd only need one of these isotopes. The bad news is the one you need is by far the most rare. U-235 is the only isotope useful for making a weapon, but it makes up less than 1% of natural uranium. If you were to try to make a bomb from natural uranium, there just wouldn't be enough of that U-235 to sustain a chain reaction and reach a supercritical mass. Conventional nuclear bombs, like the ones dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, need to be refined to about 90% U-235. But according to research out of Princeton, you could theoretically make a dirty bomb with as little as 20% enrichment. Now, I'm not sure why these professors were looking into making a bomb, but this is good news for us, because we'll have to cut these corners, because a normal person would just never be able to make a Hiroshima-style bomb. You'd need about 60 kilograms of 90% pure U-235. That would require about 12 metric tons of natural uranium and $150,000 of electricity just to refine it. Obviously, it would be pretty hard for a normal person to sneak 3 elephants worth of ore out of a mine, and the refinement process would be a huge pain. But for a 20% pure bomb, we'd only need about 2,000 kilograms, or about the weight of a Toyota Corolla. To refine the ore into a usable product, it's fed through layers of centrifuges that separate the three isotopes by their slight mass differences. There's only about a 1% difference in mass, so you'd need hundreds of centrifuges and a few years to make it work. But what if we just skip this step and let the government do it for us? Uranium needs to be enriched for things other than nuclear weapons, like for power plants and research reactors. Power plants typically enrich their ore to about 3-4%, meaning you'd only need 400 kilograms of material for an at-home bomb. Power plants like the Palo Verde Generating Station run through more than 1,600 kilograms of fuel a day, and with more than 58 nuclear power plants across the US to choose from, you have a lot of potential targets and stockpiles to choose from. Now, you might be thinking that a James Bond infiltration of a nuclear power plant is near impossible, but it's not as hard as you might imagine. In April 2009, President Obama warned the danger that terrorists could get their hands on a nuclear bomb was the most immediate and extreme threat to global security. And while American facilities are moderately well defended, according to analysts, at sites in dozens of other countries around the world, the security measures in place for enriched uranium and plutonium are literally no more than a night watchman and a chain link fence. Stealing uranium in some parts of the world is about as hard as high schoolers sneaking into their schools at night. And stealing nuclear material isn't just a hypothetical possibility, it's a proven reality. In the last 3 decades, the IAEA, the body responsible for policing the world's uranium supplies, has documented 18 thefts of large enough amounts of plutonium or enriched uranium to make a dirty bomb, and suspects dozens more thefts, where countries literally convicted individuals of uranium theft, but denied the cases to the international community. In virtually all of the known cases, no one had even noticed uranium was missing until it was later seized, suggesting that many other thefts have gone undetected. The uranium needed for a dirty bomb could fit in a suitcase and isn't radioactive enough to be dangerous or easily detected by border officials. All this means is that if a person was committed enough, there are dozens of facilities across the world where you could break in the dead of night and take all the uranium you needed. Once you have the fuel, building the weapon is actually pretty straightforward. Studies by the Pentagon have found that if individuals can get their hands on uranium or plutonium, it would be fairly easy to make at least a crude nuclear bomb. Today, making a bomb doesn't require some Manhattan-style project. In fact, even back in the 1940s, more than 90% of the Manhattan Project was devoted to making the nuclear material, not making the bomb. And that was before the basic principles of nuclear bombs were as widely known as they are today. According to the Pentagon, today, someone that has never had access to classified material could design and build a crude nuclear explosive device, and they'd only need basic machining tools that are easy to buy. To make a bomb, all you have to do is figure out a way to compress the nuclear material. This is normally done in one of two ways. The first is the gun method. The gun is considered the simplest way to build a nuclear weapon, and it's basically just ramming two pieces of nuclear fuel together. The weapon is made of a tube with two halves of nuclear fuel at opposing ends. This was how the nuclear bombs dropped on Japan worked. An explosive is placed behind one half, and when detonated, the nuclear charge races down to the other end. Once the two halves meet, the chain reaction starts and the explosion takes place. The charge in the little boy explosive dropped on Japan only needed to reach 1,000 feet or 300 meters a second, and this would be fairly easy to achieve with legal explosives like tannerite in the confined tube. The second approach is the implosion method. In this approach, the nuclear fuel is shaped into a sphere and the explosives are placed around it. When these explosives are detonated, the force compresses the fuel, setting off the chain reaction. So yeah, it turns out building a nuclear device isn't actually that hard. But before you go off and get any crazy ideas, just remember, this video was for educational purposes only. If you liked the video, be sure to check out some of our best uploads here. And remember, there is always more to learn.